Hello class, today I will be talking about LiveRec Interactive Visual Exploration of System Management Time Series Data. This paper was written by Peter McLellan, Tamara Munzer, Alfarezo, and Stephen Nort. So, going with the introduction of LiveRec, what is LiveRec? It is a visualization system that supports the analysis of large collection of system management time series data consisting of hundreds of parameters and thousands of network devices. LiveRec provides high information density and it is used for reorderable matrix charts with the semantic zooming options. Semantic zooming options is like when you want to see a part of the data, you can zoom in and see the details, and then you can squish in and out. And LiveRec allows these features, and it also allows side-by-side visual comparisons in multiple levels of details. System management. Interpreting network environment status is fundamental system management activity. It involves understanding the state of individual devices and how this state of affects overall end-to-end services. Report generation requires creating a shareable document showing relevant time series value. Capacity planning involves forecasting future systems and infrastructure needs. An LCE, who is a engineer, has participated in summarizing its three phases. So the phase one is where we already have what customers need. And in the phase two, it provides short-term recommendation, which is like 1 to 3 months. And in phase three, there's long-term work where we can provide recommendations. For example, changing of a particular application or upgrading the version of that application. Event investigation concerns specific events such as service outage or network security breach. Coordination between customer, engineers, and operation involves communicating and finding change request and recommendation. Iterative system. LiveRec is an iterative system, meaning that it has different phases and it keeps iterating until the overall system is refined and it is error-free. So the methodology behind it is the study start with prototypes and it continues to a proof of concept interactive software prototype using the synthetic data. And then it leads to a high fidelity prototype running on a real data. And finally, to deploy that system into the production. But before that, the testing is done and the testing will be done until the prototype is refined. For this experiment, we took the different participants. So we had in total 14 participants. One who was outside the company, he's the CTO. The second member is within the company and he is like a tool engineer team. And third one is executive director. Then we have four senior technical directors and then we have seven LCEs. In the design phase, the first phase with the initial requirement gathering interview with C1, who is the CTO. In the second phase, developed a high fidelity prototype running on the production database and collect the feedback. This second prototype was presented to E1 and D1. In the phase, we gather requirement in meetings with executive and the director in addition to the team member. And the results were presented to all the senior technical directors. And in the fourth phase, they gathered all the requirements from all the LCEs through the meetings and surveys, and then they deployed the system into the production environment. In conclusion, the data was collected, log of 38 sessions from a total of 13, and live RAC systems were used. LCs L1 to L4 were the more interactive users, with the total 24 logged session between four of them. Coming to the next slide, a visualization solution. LiveRack is one of the many visualization systems that use matrix layout. Interactive reorderable matrix visualization were introduced by Burton. In this, we can see the semantic zooming. It is a technique used in this paper where the objects adapt their visual representation to the available screen space. For example, there's a calendar. If you want to see, if this space is very limited, we can show just 1 month. But if we have enough space, we can show up till the whole calendar for a year. So this is an example of semantic zooming. And then we also have stretch and squish navigation technique. It is an interaction metaphor where user manipulates the display as it was a rubber sheet tackled down to the borders. So you can expand it and squish it. And finally, the time series data is an area of extensive study in information visualization research. So we also do have a lot of time series data. So we have four principles. Principle: familiar visualization representation should be preserved when appropriate. And in the diagram, as you can see, the side-by-side comparison of small multiple views is easier than remembering previously seen views. Spatial position is the strongest perceptual cue. And the columns can be sorted according to the parameter values. For example, minimum or maximum or mean or medium or the average of the time series. And multiple views are the most effective when coordinated through the explicit linking in live RSC in this paper. As the user moves the cursor within the chart, the same point in time is marked in all the charts with the vertical line. User scenario. This figure divided into part A, B, C, D. A shows a scenario one where LC started with an overview of 50 devices at the lowest semantic zoom level, where color block shows the maximum values of each parameter for each device. Figure C shows where an LC was showing a colleague a sorted trend information over a period of months. So when he stretched the cells for devices showing the top CPU usage, he discovered that a system had stopped reporting shortly after hitting like 100%. So both LC agreed that the behavior is indicated a problem and it should needs to be rectified. And in figure D over here, it shows a scenario three where an LCA was inspecting a group of web servers in the same load balance pool. These servers are intended to have a similar behavior. But after expanding those cells, he saw that some devices that load had unexpectedly dropped to almost zero for a few weeks. Yet they have not crashed and continue to report all their monitor parameters. The LCA said that he would follow up with colleague who was responsible for the system. In conclusion, I would like to say that LiveRack is a Java-based application, and it is already deployed in the production environment. LiveRack provides high-density data and can infer more than dashboard approach. So in dashboard, we cannot have as much detailed information as LiveRack can show, because it provides details on demand in a detailed fashion. And LiveRack has ongoing support from its users, with the prospect of wider deployment in the other network management and planning application. Thank you.